Hello and welcome to this video in which I will be sharing 5 tips with you that you can apply overnight in order to boost your language level. So in case you're a little bit insecure about your language level right now and you want it to be higher, more fluent, more conversational, then this is the video for you. So let's go. Before I give you the first tip, I want to say that language levels are really subjective. They aren't set in stone. We don't have objective measurements of what a language level of someone is really at, because it all depends on the moment, it depends on the person you're talking to, depends on what you're talking about. It really, really depends on the moment. And so let's take advantage of that. Let's make sure that we take those moments and really showcase our language level. So tip number one is showing confidence. The more you show that you're comfortable and confident speaking your target language, you will be perceived as having a higher language level. And you might sound that that's cheating, but it really isn't, because the more comfortable you feel talking the language and the more confident you seem, the more comfortable the person you're talking to will feel as well. Because if I, when I make this video, sit like this and my voice is really low, then the conversation or this video wouldn't be as effective. It wouldn't be as nice to listen to me in case I don't show any confidence. So really, let's do something about that confidence in order to boost your language level. And so the first thing about confidence I have to mention is body language. And in order to be perceived as confident, even if on the inside you don't really feel so confident, is really taking in more space, roll your shoulders back, and just really feel that space, feel that confidence, versus if my shoulders are like this, I don't feel comfortable in the conversation. So just roll back those shoulders. That's the most important thing when you're having a conversation with someone. And the second tip when it comes to showing confidence is in your intonation. Because if you doubt every single word you're saying, you will hear it in your voice. Your intonation will go up many times because you're not sure. And so that's not something, again, that your conversation partner will feel really comfortable with, because the conversation is slow, because you question every word. And so if you want to be perceived as having a higher language level, then the way to go is really, as I mentioned, rolling those shoulders back and sticking to a normal conversation intonation. Got it? Okay, let's go to tip number two. Tip number two is about creativity. Use the words that you already know and the grammatical structures you already know, and use those that you feel comfortable with. Again, if you use a word or a grammatical structure you've heard many, many times before, you will feel more comfortable and it will make you feel more confident as well. And by doing this, you have a more fluent conversation. You're using the grammatical structure and the words you know are likely to be correct. And very often we're bombarded with grammatical rules in a language class, or if you open a grammar book, and that can make us feel really insecure. And in that way, it can actually lower our language level, because language levels are graded by how fluent we are and what speed we talk at. Of course, the more mistakes you make, the lower the level, but the speed is just as important. So really be creative with your words and stick to this normal conversation speed. If you don't know a word, then try to describe it and just make the sentence a little bit longer, but don't slow down. For example, if you want to borrow a pen from someone, but you forgot the word pen in your target language, then try to describe it at normal conversation speed. Say something like, "Hey, do you have something I can write with? I have to fill out this form." Something I can write with. And that's just as valid as, "Hey, do you have a pen?" But you see that I stuck to this normal conversation speed. So it didn't seem like I was lacking a lot of words or I had a low level in the language. It just really seemed that it was a natural conversation, even if I didn't know the word. And I do this even with grammatical structures, because Very often there is a ton of ways to describe the same thing. For example, there are so many tenses we use to talk about the future or to talk about the past. Just choose one and stick to that normal conversation speed, using your words creatively to let the conversation flow. Now, tip number three. Tip number three is about being prepared for a certain situation. So if you know you're going to be in a specific situation, just as meeting your parents-in-law or going to the doctor or a job interview, why don't you prepare for that specific situation by having prepared some questions you want to ask, by having prepared some sentences you're very likely to need in that situation, and some words you didn't know before? I certainly do this. If I go to the doctor here in Peru, I live in Peru, there might be some words that I'd forgotten, and I just quickly Google them because I know I will need them. As soon as I talk to the doctor, I need those words. So just really think beforehand, if you're going on a language exchange, if you're going to meet people at a language exchange, then why don't you prepare for that? It's very likely that you're going to talk about movies and series and where you're from, what you do for a living. So why don't you look up those things before you go there so that you can actually have a more interesting conversation and a conversation at a higher level. So that was tip number three. Now, tip number four has all to do with questions. By asking a lot of questions, the conversation will become more interesting, but also you have time to get used to the person you're talking to. You have time to steal some of the words you heard in there or the grammatical structures. And then by the time the question comes back to you, you will feel more comfortable to answer it. You've had a role model, basically. So if you talk to native speakers and you ask them, hey, what movies do you like? You kind of hear the words they're saying, and for example, they might mention, oh, I'm watching this in this series, and I'm in episode number 16. And then you might have just learned the word episode, and then you can use it in your answer. So asking your conversation partner questions is super useful in case you're not so confident about your own level. And as I said, it also gives you time to just relax, roll your shoulders back, breathe, and feel more comfortable talking to this person. And also by listening to this person and just saying yes, like, you are perceived as having a higher level, but also it gives you time to get used to this language and speaking to this person. Now, last but definitely not least, tip number five. Tip number five is about pronunciation. And years ago, I wasn't a fan of pronunciation. I thought it was really difficult to get a native-like accent. However, it is something that can be trained. And you might wonder why. The power of pronunciation is so strong because even people that have like an A1 level but really manage to get a super native accent will be perceived as having a higher level. Even by just saying some words, people are like, wow, you speak this language very well. And so there is a certain power of pronunciation. It is because we like people that are similar to us. And so if someone has a really native-like accent, so which would be a similar accent to yours in your own language, then you're like, hey, this person really understands my culture and really understands me. So it is nice to work on pronunciation, and it's actually really fun to do. You can do it with language apps. For example, if you have a language app with a lot of audios, it's really easy to press that audio multiple times and then try to imitate that audio. And we call that shadowing. It's really, really effective. I done it with Italiano and I thought it was amazing. I thought it was really nice with language apps, just trying to imitate the small audios you hear on there and really being aware of, okay, if a word ends with this letter, it sounds like this. If a word starts with these two letters, it sounds like that. And really analyzing those vowels. Where do you feel it in your mouth? Where's your tongue? Where's the sound being produced? Is it in your throat or is it more at the front? by trying to imitate the audio from, for example, language apps, you start feeling that the sound is in a specific area of your mouth. And so just keep on practicing and it will get better. And it's so worth it, I'm telling you, because people will think not only that your language level is really good, but also they will feel like you understand their culture better and you're one of them. So that is really, really nice. Now, these were my 5 tips for today. I really hope you like them. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me on Instagram at Polyglot Insight. And of course, start following this YouTube channel as well as my Instagram to receive more language learning tips. See you in the next video. Bye bye.